Hello, I'm Robert from the Dr. Bubble channel on YouTube. How are you? I'm back with another tips video, although more accurately, it's more or less discussing these newer tools inside 3ds Max. Now, the previous one was discussing constraints, make planar, and view align, which are not new, but when you're starting off using Max, you may not naturally know about them or actually experiment with them. So, I recommend watching the previous one. That said, these tools are more exclusive to the newer incarnations of 3ds Max. I believe they're more exclusive to version 2010 upwards. This subject, I must add, is about connection, as you can tell. Doesn't take an Einstein to work that one out, but it's just newer ways of connecting between edges, and for flow connect, how can you maintain topology. So we're going to go through those one by one. So let's move on. Now, first up is distance connect. Now, if you read the actual description up here, creates connections between sub-objects across distance and other topology. So, for example, if I wanted to actually add a edge loop from here to there, I could do so naturally. The orthodox way would be just to click on it and press connect. Not a problem. The quicker way of selecting edge loops is to hold down shift and click one and click the other beside it, and it does it in one lump sum. You can actually can just delete these off. The other way, if we wanted to add resolution from here to there, would be obviously selecting the desired edges and pressing distance connect. And there you have it, it does it in one lump sum. It does this from a vertical point of view and horizontally as well. So that's a very time-saving tool itself. And I found that I've been using this more and more as time goes on. However, the problem is on some primitive objects is that it doesn't always work. For example, if I wanted to choose this edge here and here and press distance connect, instead of just connecting between these two lines, the computer will actually calculate all the way around, which you don't really want. You may want, but however, it does actually work if you do it on the vertical. So there you have it. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Whether it's meant to work like this, I'm not too sure. So that's distance connect for you. Next is new connect, or as I call it, connect, which is I believe just the same feature that you have down here on connect. But the good thing is, if you select here and here, and now you can naturally connect this 90-degree angle up. So if you just press connect, and there and now you've got yourself a connection between two lines. Let me just see if I can work this one out. If you press build corner, then it builds it into quads for you. So if you're concerned about quadrilation, then again you could try doing that. So select this line here and you can build corner. So there you have it. So that's another useful feature, actually, another build corner feature. So that's worth knowing as well. Even though you can still connect edges using the usual feature on connect, so you can actually press connect and you still actually connect these lines from here and from down there. But bear in mind the actual build corner function as well, because that comes hand in hand if you want to keep your mesh in quads. So connect is not really a new tool, it's actually an old tool, but it's just giving it a bit of a you could say a spring clean with the graphite modelling tools, but they do almost identical things. Well, they do identical things in hindsight, but remember the build corner feature, because that's very useful to know about as well. So to finish off with is the last one, which is called Flow Connect, which definitely is a new tool inside 3ds Max, unlike the Connect tool, which I discussed in the previous demo. And the Flow Connect, if I read the actual description, you can just click on the edge here, for example. It reads, connects selected edges across one or more edge rings and adjusts the new loop position to fit the shape of the surrounding mesh. So, for example, let me just show you a way. Now, on this poorly made glass, as you can see, this edge or edges of press F4 on and off, it's got a kind of a smooth rounded over appearance. Okay, now if I delete those inner, was it one, two, those inner edges, you can see this is what it would actually look like if I deleted those inner edge loops inside. So how do I build these back? Just for example, if you go and select an edge and press again, shift and click, and obviously it selects the rings for you. You can obviously do it, ring it from down here. Now if you go up to the actual Flow Connect now and press it, you can see it actually adds and calculates between this line and that line where to put the actual edge loop, and actually instead of you using this to actually adjust it, it actually calculates it into a rounded over edge just like the previous one. So if you add another one and press Flow Connect, as you can see, it started to resemble the original over here. So it's very useful indeed, and it produces a nice clean effect. So if I do it once more, Flow Connect again, and now you can see I've got more or less the same effect with lesser edges compared to with this one here. But in essence, it actually calculates between edges and fills in the missing parts, but it does give a pleasing effect to your mesh. So that's one to experiment with in your own time, but it's worth knowing again. So that said, hopefully you found this of interest to you, and please experiment and get used to the tools inside 3ds Max. Again, like I said previously, you know, technique is most important, and getting to know what tool is best for what purpose inside 3ds Max is essential. Anyway, hopefully you can put a thumbs up, that always helps the videos out. If there's any questions, etc., please post them, I always like to read them. Have a good day and happy modelling.